through with the chance with Williams in front of the net. So far, so good for the Capitals.
Olimata shot patted right back out into some trouble, and a penalty is coming up. It's okay. Going to be on the Capitals.
Oh, Brooks Orpik lit Olimata right up. He's going to get a penalty for this. Chris Stewart, the athletic trainer.
Better hold on to him there.
Yep. They got to help him out. We were just talking about Brooks Orpik and how physical he can be. Watch this. That's high, it's hard,
and
that's devastating and late. Absolutely.
Washington 44 has 2 minutes interference.
A minor for interference. And Mata in rough shape.
Oh, he's in rough shape. That is a rough interference. Watch the shoulder come right up with the forearm.
Orpik sits. Mata will be tended to. Penguins to the power play. It is sponsored by the Lincoln Motor Company.
Certainly looked like the principal point of contact was the head area of Olli Mata.
So it is Letang getting things engineered here. In game one, the Penguins did not strike on the power play.
This one tonight is suspendable. If they don't suspend this guy, there is no justice. There should be a protest in Pittsburgh. He picks the head. It's about a second late after he passes the puck. He's a predator. We know that. He looks for people who are vulnerable. He's done it in the past. Mata is vulnerable here. He gets the chicken wing out there. He picks the head. I don't see body contact. If there are other tapes out there, maybe the league has them. But watch the elbow. Bang. Right there to the side of Mata's head. If you want to stop headshots, you got to stop this hit. This is a suspendable offense. Obviously distressed, hurt Mata. Top four defenseman out of the game with an illegal hit. That guy needs to go.
It's suspendable alone because of the interference. That came a second after the puck was released. They'll try to determine whether or not the principal point of contact was the head. Mata's head was down a little bit. He did turn. But here's Orpik, and in my mind, he's picking the head as well. The league will look at it at every angle that they have, and they'll try to determine whether or not he went through Mata's body first. It does not look like that on the replays that we have, and Orpik got lucky that it was only a two-minute minor
clear
penalty.
Lifting of his arm here. You can see the extension come out with the elbow hitting first. If there's another angle, I'll look at it, but from what we've seen, this is a tough one.
Here's a guy who has been suspended two previous times. It's been a while, though, 2003, 2006. It won't really factor in terms of repeat offender, but that is on his record. So what would be justice in terms of a suspension?
The league usually dials it down when it's playoffs. I'm not sure how we could have that conversation some other time. It's at least two games. It's at least two games for this hit.
Right.
There's a guy that's in trouble, Mata, and a top four defenseman,
right,
and a very late hit. It's
tough. It was a key player. It would be three games during the regular season. In my mind, it would be at least one playoff game, which is significant. But Orpik got away with what should have been a 5-minute major on the X.